Hey guys, I just wanted to do an update video as to what's going on with the channel and all that kind of stuff. And right now we are in the middle of restoring a 1977 Camaro. So me and my son have kind of strayed a little bit from the pocket knives and the archery and the guns and stuff to start messing with cars now. He's 12, so he's starting to get more into that kind of thing. And it's pretty cool. I can say that I'm definitely into it as well. So right now the entire interior is stripped out. We're down to the metal. Like I said, a 77. We've got the light dangling here trying to get some better close-up video, but we do have some rust spots you can see. That's not actually a hole there. That's actually a random spot of clean paint. But we do have some holes here. I've got one back here. It's all the way through. That's the garage floor. So I'm going to have to replace that seat pan area. Chances are the one on the passenger side as well in the back. That's a bunch of residue from like the little, what do they call that stuff? It's like a jute matting or something like that underneath the, I mean, we're all familiar with jute twine, but I guess this is a jute matting that's underneath the carpet, like original to the cars or whatever. So that crap's all molded and gross and nasty. So everything's coming out. This started life as a 1977 Camaro LT. And it's got a couple of things done to it here lately. We've got an Edelbrock carburetor on top of a 350. This has been swapped in versus the 305 that it came with. Everything's kind of in a dirty position right now, but we'll get there eventually. It's pretty cool, so I just kind of wanted to give a little update video. I just got the sandblaster squared away today, and the new air compressor, and all that kind of stuff. So I'm going to start sandblasting the floors. I'm going to run everything as far as paint-wise with the POR 15, the Paint Over Rust 15. This stuff, I just got 2 quarts of black, and got it off of Amazon. It was like $30. Oh, hold on, I take that back. Like $39 or something like that. Amazon Prime. So, apparently this stuff you can paint right over rust or whatever. Of course, I'm going to strip a little bit of it beforehand. But apparently it does pretty good. I've got a neighbor who's restoring a 77 Corvette right now. And he's using everything. He's stripped all the way down, like, to birdcage. So he's pretty into it. Luckily, I bought this thing with a lot of the stuff already done. And not like a mid-project, but, you know, a kid was in the Navy, got stationed somewhere else, left at his dad's house, and the dad just needed it gone. So we picked it up. It wasn't running. Got it running in a couple of days. And then now we're down to stripping interior. There's no rust in the trunk at all, which is really cool. And the only spots that look like they've leaked are back here at the, I don't even know what you call this, the back right-hand corner of the car, but around that window, it's leaked and caused some rust spots there. And then, I guess really, everything's set on back here, so probably the rear windshield area has been leaking or something like that. So, got quite a bit to do. The door panels are still in the car. They look nasty, so they're going to have to get changed. This was a cloth top or a hard top cloth top or whatever the heck you want to call that stupid crap where they just put this junk leather over the metal and it starts making little rust spots. Let's see, I've got some rust spots in here somewhere. I know there's a couple here that we just kind of messed with, but you know, it starts bubbling up and getting all nasty and everything, which is ridiculous. But like I said, the trunk is really good. Started taking all the little trim off around the windows. And let's see, I'll walk you through the garage here. Here is our list of stuff we gotta do. The list keeps growing like all the time, so. And it's a lot of stuff today. And we got the cost on the right hand side. So we paid $1,500 for the car. We had it towed from a city about an hour away, or a town about an hour away, for $250 on a Sunday. The new battery was $89. The oil was, you know, oil and that type of things, $60. The fuel line stuff, $30. And I mean, a lot of this kind of is just grouped together, but I wanted to keep a fairly accurate cost tally. And then the tools at $400. I got the sandblaster and a replacement air compressor from Harbor Freight today. So got all that stuff stuck in. Got the reel and everything underneath the counter, so I know nobody cares about that stuff. But either way, that's where we're at. So pretty excited. We'll see what happens. Anyways, just wanted to do a quick video. It's been like a long time since videos have been done. In case anybody's wondering, I still definitely drink beer and still play with knives and bows and guns and stuff all the time. I just never do videos about it anymore. The boys are older now, so we've kind of gotten away from that kind of thing, and we spend a lot of time doing this kind of stuff, so, and working on the motorcycles. Anyways, I appreciate you watching. Have a good time.